I'm really interested in this because that's quite a long time in data, right? And I was wondering how were things different 14 years ago? Because I know that there are stories about how things looked like 10 years ago when the big data was just kind of kicking off. But 14 years ago, it's yet a different story probably, right? Did you see all of this big data technologies evolve like in very initial ones, right? How did it look like back then?
Yes, indeed. I mean, 14 years ago, that was like the beginning of the, I guess you can say, big data revolution in a way. It's very much kind of similar how we are with the MLOps in the last few years, right? There's a lot of innovation. There's a lot of, obviously, that is a common need across the many companies. So back then, there was a lot of open source technology as well. You probably remember Apache Hadoop, right? I don't know if you remember MapReduce and Hadoop file systems. that was the beginning that started everything. And then after that, there's a lot of innovation about how to make it easier to use your distributed data processing. So you probably remember Apache Pig that came out of Yahoo Lab. And then Apache Hive came out of Facebook. All these are built on top of like MapReduce concepts, essentially.
It was to make it easier, basically.
Exactly. To make it easier because you have data scientists, you have data analysts, just want to be able to crunch large amount of data. Writing MapReduce is not the easiest thing in the world.
Conceptually, it is easy, but...
Yeah, but writing is almost like writing assembly code compared to how you would write a SQL statement nowadays with Apache Hive and Spark. Yeah. And then after that, you know, the Apache Spark came around from the Berkeley lab. Right. Very same concept. How do we make it easier to do distributed data processing at large scale, essentially? And then there's a whole bunch of other technologies around. Okay, how do I schedule my workflow? How do I schedule all these pipelines? So workflow scheduling system or orchestration technology came around. You probably heard of Airflow. So back then I remember had a conversation with Maxime from Airbnb when Airflow was started in the early days. Because at LinkedIn, when I was there, we had our own workflow scheduling system called Askaban. Intrally was created there. So we were just evaluating our options. So I had a chat with Maxime when Airbnb came out. Sorry, the Airflow came out of Airbnb.
You mentioned that you use the term big data revolution. And I remember going to conferences like Hadoop World, etc. I don't know whether they are still happening. I don't know. But in a retrospective, do you see that this big data revolution was a really revolution or rather a transition period to what we are building now or a building block to really start using data via machine learning models, or
I think it's a enabler, definitely the big data revolution kind of enabler for now where we are in terms of leveraging large amount of data for building models in terms of building features. When you're dealing with a large complex model like search or recommendations, they tend to need a lot of data. But data is not just for machine learning, but also for analytics, for all kinds of other functions that company needs to be able to, you know, extract insights, analyze them, and leverage them to improve their business. Either, you know, building competitive products or improving their analysis in terms of what's going on in their product portfolios or customers and such. So it's very fascinating to see, you know, how the big data revolution enable all these kind of things, but also now is the enabler for machine learning era that we are in right now.